Thank you.
Hello, everyone. It's Rachel with Rachel's Spice Company. And today, we're going to make chicken noodle soup. Yeah, chicken noodle soup. I know it sounds so simple, right? Most of you maybe go to the supermarket, open a can of chicken noodle. Well, let me tell you, you do not have to do that anymore because chicken noodle is super easy to make. It's so much healthier for you. You can make it with no preservatives and it just tastes amazing. And I bet you're expecting this. I make a chicken soup seasoning. It's the seasoning I used at my cafe back in the day. Everybody would always ask me, why does your chicken noodle taste so much better? Why is your chicken noodle actually filmy and warmy? And it's, well, top secret ingredient in my chicken soup seasoning that if you buy it, you'll see it on the side of the label, okay? All right, so chicken noodle is chicken noodle. So we're gonna start with chicken, right? So a little word about chicken. There's a couple different ways that you can do this. If you've gone to the store, and you've gotten one of those lovely rotisserie chickens. I cannot be the only one that literally like almost lives off these, right? They're so convenient. You can get the organic ones now. You can get no preservative ones. You can get flavored ones or just, and everybody does them. Up here in my neck of the woods, it's like Price Chopper, Hannaford, Walmart. I don't know if Aldi does them. Haven't been to Aldi in a hot second. So, but these are a lifesaver. So you could literally use this carcass to make your own chicken broth. You would just put it in water, make sure it's covered in water. Super bonus if you have some celery, onions, garlic, anything like that to throw in there. And you just simmer it. It's like a Sunday project, right? Put it in the water, simmer it. You can put it in a crock pot, have it cooking while you're at work. So anyways, if you have one of these laying around, you can make your own chicken broth. Super awesome. I also like to use the chicken from these if I have a little bit left over. I also like to make chicken salad out of it too. So sometimes it's a toss up what I'm going to do with it. So actually I've done that. I've taken the breasts off of the chicken and I've diced them up. You could also, so you don't have a rotisserie chicken around, kicking around. Maybe you're just swinging by the grocery store real quick already. Maybe you have frozen chicken breasts in the freezer. So here I've literally just cooked two chicken breasts. That's what I've done. I've got two chicken breasts. Well, it looks like there's something on top of there. Yes, a little loaded salt and pepper, a little Rachel Ray favorite right there. I've got another soup cooking here on the back. I'm gonna turn her off. I am a soup machine today. All right, so what do we need to start with? We've got our chicken. Well, we need to start with the actual soup part, right? So I'm a little clumsy today. Sorry about that, guys. So this is a very old container. I know, it looks pretty beat up, but it's just one of those containers that has a lot of memories. I really love it. This has been with me through all of my restaurants. Made a lot of stuff with this little container. So in here I have chicken broth that I have made from chicken base. It's kind of like a restaurant-y kind of product. You can buy it on Amazon though. I've never seen it in a regular grocery store, but it is my favorite. And sometimes I have a hard time getting away from my restaurant roots. But you can also use good old-fashioned boxed chicken broth. You, like I said, you can make your own chicken broth from the rotisserie chicken. I just don't suggest bouillon because it's really super salty. I do not like how salty bouillon makes my soups. You would literally have to put like no extra salt in it and that's no fun. So there's my chicken broth. But wait, there's more. So I do this really weird thing. Whenever I make a poultry-based soup, I actually do chicken and turkey broth mixed together. Something about it is just absolutely fantastic. So this is just a quart of each. If you can't find turkey, don't worry about it, just use chicken. If you can't find chicken, use turkey. Something about the two of them together though just adds an extra level of flavor. All right. So there we go. I got those in there. I'm gonna put my chicken in here. This is literally as simple as this gets, guys. You do not need a culinary degree to make your family wholesome chicken noodle soup. This is literally just frozen vegetables right out of the freezer section. It's green beans, peas, carrots, corn. Super simple. It's 2 cups, so nothing crazy. And you can change up the veggies. Do whatever vegetables you want in there. It's your soup. Make it your way. All right. And then the magic. This is a tablespoon of my chicken soup seasoning. I always suggest you start with the least amount that I require, which is a tablespoon, because everybody's tastes are different. So we're gonna light her up. Here I am chilling in my mom's kitchen again. She's amazing for letting me use her kitchen. So that is literally it. You're just gonna simmer this until the veggies are cooked. Chicken's not gonna be falling apart. It's gonna be super delish. Guys, check out this ladle. How funny is this ladle? Little messy ladle. So you're gonna go to serve this up to your family. Look at that, super full. You can do more, you can do less. I'm not gonna lie, in the cold winter months up here in upstate New York, sometimes I will literally just make the broth to sip on. Nessie didn't want to stand up. Just, it's great sipping broth. Put it in a mug and just sip away on it. It just makes you feel so warm, so comforted. Noodles. I put my noodles in as I eat my soup because I do not like mushy noodles. Some people like that though. Some people like that starchiness when the noodles get cooked in there. So put the noodles in whenever you want. Put it in right after you make it. Put them in to order like I do. You can heat them up a little bit if they're cold. Totally up to you. But I like firmer egg noodles in my soup. So I like to put them in as I serve them. So I'll put a little bit of noodle in the bowl, ladle the soup over the noodles, and there you have it. And because I'm a pepper girl, I like salt, but in very, very small amounts. This is my 5-star pepper. I'm just gonna sprinkle a little of that on top. That is totally however you wanna work it, right? So I know I like pepper. So I'm putting extra pepper in mine. The blend already has pepper in it, but my 5-star pepper has some other fantastic ingredients in it, like celery seed. So it makes it really zippy. So this is gonna be a warm, comforting, zippy chicken soup. And I'm just gonna let that warm through until it's hot. You don't need to really boil it. You just need to make sure those vegetables are done. And that is it. That's all you need to do for chicken noodle soup. You need my chicken soup seasoning. You need some basic pantry staples. And you need about 10-15 minutes of your time, unless you need to cook your chicken. Then you need like an extra half an hour. But it's a great weeknight meal. You can make it in the crock pot. You can make it in the instant pot. Look in the description of this video for the full recipe. If you like what you see, like it, subscribe. I'm Rachel from Rachel's Spice Company. Make sure you check out www.rachelspicecompany.com if you want to get yourself some chicken soup seasoning. That's it. Thanks so much for watching. Peace out. Peace out!